Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabid here. Today, we're taking a look at the current state of crypto mining on GPUs, CPUs, FPGAs, as well as ASICs. What is crypto mining profits looking like currently for the month of May? Not as good as they used to be. All right, so starting off, 11 cents per kilowatt hour, and we're under a dollar on the world's greatest mining GPU. The RTX 4090 is only at 84 cents, and that's with dual mining iron plus pyron. So that actually kind of sucks. 2 months ago, we were upwards of $4 to $5 a day on this coin, or on this GPU, I guess. We still have the CMP 170HX. I do believe that was second last month as well, coming at only 57 cents now, thanks to Ironfish, where they did boost that memory there, kind of like Ethereum mining. I'll just scroll down here. Obviously, you guys can see what's happening there, but I like to grade everything based on the RTX 3070, as that is the most popular GPU that most people have in their little home mining farms here, and that's only at 18 cents. So that's 11 cents per kilowatt hour. Let's bump this up to 15 cent power just to see what the 3070 is looking like right now. The 3070 is only at 1 cent. 15 cent power is pretty much break even right now when it comes to the RTX 3070. That's not very good. Not very good at all in terms of the market. It has been going down. Hash rate has also been slowly picking up, as well as GPUs have been pulling off certain networks. Like I believe Radiant is getting pulled off because it's getting smashed with an FPGA farm. Alephium slowly has gold shell ASICs, but that's also getting smashed out with an FPGA farm. And then there's another one, Kylocoin. GPUs weren't really on that one. It was always FPGA anyway, but the same FPGA farm smashed that out. So GPUs are looking for other homes. So the network hash rate has been slowly picking up on all the other coins. Now, coming into the CPU side of things, the 3900X, just one of those little guys, courtesy of rabidmining.com, which is my website. Head on over, guys, and check it out. But we got Yatacoin coming in at 31 cents, 11 cents per kilowatt hour again. Avian's 31, Dagger's 23. ZEP is down to 21 cents. The price is only $8.24. So again, the market has been coming down. Everything's been pretty low lately. Raptorium's at 17 cents here. Bittorium's at 8 cents. Let's bump this up to a better GPU here. I guess CPU up to the 7950X. We're going to load that bad boy up here. See what it's looking like. This is 67 cents after power, 54 cents. Zephyr is up to 50 cents. Not too shabby. Let's pick this up kind of like we looked at with the 3070 to 15 cent power here. And now we can see 51, 41. Zephyr is at 34 cents. So obviously that's a lot better than 1 cent that you would have on a 3070. But then again, a 7950X is probably a couple hundred dollars more than you could find for a single 3070. But it is making about 34 times the profit currently. And then the big bad boy Epic, which started to get overpriced lately, probably isn't worth your money, but some of you guys have been picking up Epics. That is $1.14 on Yada. AVN is $1.01. Dagger is 84 cents. Zeph is at 78 cents after power. Raptorium, 51 cents. Bittorium, 22 cents. That's crazy. Bittorium is still hanging around here. I haven't mined that coin forever, and I don't even know if I ever will. All right. ASICs. Bump, bump. Bum. So we got the Bitmain KS5 Pro again, as usual, for the past 8 or 9 months now. Kaspa mining has been the dominant force in profitability, and we can see $84 a day. I've got 15 cents per kilowatt hour here, so we're kind of comparing this to GPUs and everything else. Obviously, ASICs are expensive, but if you are looking for your own ASIC miner, check the links down in the description so you don't get ripped off by scam fake websites. We have the Gold Shell AL box coming in at $46 right now. Let's just look at something right here. Look at SHA, you know, which is Bitcoin miners. Look at the profitability. They were upwards of $20 to $30 a day right at the halving. The fees spiked. Everything was going crazy. All the Bitcoin miners were pumped up, excited, and happy. Now they're making jack squat. Zero. Nothing. So 3,200 watts, you're making $1.55 a day. This is a 15% kilowatt or 15 cent. I'm going to put this to 11 cent like we usually look at here. Put in the SHA thing again, so it's something for me. It is up a little bit compared to what it was the other day. The 15 cent was the same as the 11 cent as 2 days ago or something like that. But yeah, so SHA 56, you know, Bitcoin type ASICs, $3.71 for over 3,000 watts. Let's just look at the Bitmain's greatest mine. That's crazy. The HS6 is outperforming Bitmain's. Oh, this can mine multi-algo. Why is it? Wait a minute. This can't even mine Bitcoin. What am I talking about? I want SHA-256. That's all I want here. Why is those ones popping up? All right, so we got the S21 Pro back to Bitmain's largest and greatest best miner minus the Hydra here, $1.23, 96 cents. And then every other one is not making anything. Bitcoin mining, they use so much power, and home miners, I really don't think should be buying Bitcoin miners themselves. They're loud, they cause a lot of heat, they use a crap ton of power, and they don't make anything. So think about it. If ordinals think they will pick up in the future again, as the Bitcoin network does gain more and more traction and we get closer to that main bull run, you know, transactions will be happening, fees will go up again, and they're going to see some nice days. But on average, you're not making very much. And in theory, Bitcoin could go to $120,000, which is over double of the current price. And this would double. In theory, you're only making $2 at $120,000 Bitcoin. You can see how it's not looking very good to be a home miner with Bitcoin. You're competing with massive farms at 2 or 3 cent power, with farms that own their own freaking power supplies and power plants, and it's just insane. A home miner cannot compete with the world of Bitcoin mining farms. So take this off your radar if you're really debating it. Unless you really want to waste power, you just want to support a network, by all means, go for it. But I definitely do not recommend Bitcoin miners for anybody. Now, coming back into everything else with 11 cents per kilowatt hour again, we see everything else is actually doing not too bad, even in this down market. So obviously we have Kaspa miners leading the charge across them all. We got L7s here happening. They're at $7 to $8. We're going to see increased hash rates soon as the L9 and stuff releases, so this will drop. But remember, you know, the majority of all your mining on the Script miners is coming from Dogecoin. So you can't split, you know, 50% LTC, 50% Doge, when 80% of the profits is actually coming from Doge. Litecoin could go down to literally zero, and if Doge pumps to $1, you're going to be making a crap ton of money here. But again, you know, keep that in mind. The ratio here, the majority of the profits is Dogecoin and Dogecoin only. And, you know, so far it's doing decent. As we hit that bull run, could Doge see $1? That's pretty much what you're gambling on with one of these type of ASICs. But we do have L9s, possible hash blades and stuff coming later on. So we're going to see a spike in network hash, making these current miners either drop in price, which in theory they should, and the profitability will be dropping as well. But, you know, ASICs are still, you know, a pretty decent thing other than a Bitcoin ASIC. The other ones, the main ones, Kaspa, Script, and you know, there might be a couple other ones, maybe Kadena if it sees a pump again, you know, are looking pretty good. All right, so FPGAs here took a massive hit, and the funny thing is Alephium is actually still profitable on some of these FPGAs. But you know, like the E300, that's what these top numbers are based on. Ironfish is gone now, and then the C1100 is down here. I've only really tested iron or Alephium, so it's all the numbers I have. The coal engine's pretty good, but I also feel if you didn't check out that actual review on the P2X, then check it out. But it's an extremely loud FPGA, but for the money, it's one of the biggest bangs for your buck. You get a lot of hash rate and very good efficiencies here. I don't have the numbers in here, sadly. I apologize. I will try to get this updated to have that coal engine added into here as well. But E300 here, we do have Kyla coin is at negative $1.06 right now at 532 watts, 11 cent power. So that's out of the question. The FPGA farm took it over. As we can see, look right here, Kyla coin. This all an FPGA spike happened at the same time it took it over. It's past the date where it came online, so we can't really show you exactly. But all three coins, Kyla coin, Radiant, and Alephium, all got smashed at the exact same time by the exact same farm, and he's pushing everybody out of the market pretty much. So coming in now at Radiant, that's at negative 52 cents. That is pretty darn sad here. Alephium is making 96 cents, but again, this is like a $4,000 to $5,000 miner, the E300, to make 96 cents a day. That's not looking too hot. If the bull run comes and maybe Alephium hits $10 to $50, that'd be absolutely awesome. But right now it's still not looking too hot. And then on the C1100, Ironfish is gone. Alephium is, oh, I got something messed up because it's saying
$44 a day. That is absolutely not correct.
Okay, so this is actually 360. The AL box from Gold Shell is about $44 a day. The C1100 is actually about 5.8 gigahash or so. Bam, we're coming in. So this is only making 25 cents a day. Still not too shabby, but again, a C1100 is like $2,200 USD. So it's expensive for only 25 cents a day. Anyway, guys, thank you for checking out this video. The current state of crypto mining, not looking too hot, but don't worry, the bull run's coming. Things will look a lot better. And right now is the time to get them yields, because you want to get the yields now. Once the spikes happen, that's when you sell, because the network hash rates are going to explode and those yields will drop. Even though your profitability is looking decent, you're not going to be making very many coins. Thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.